હલો હલો બેરિયા, ગુડી ગુડ મોર્નિંગ. કારણ કે અત્યારે અહીંયા વાગ્યા છે 6:30 સવારના, અને અમે લેટ નથી યાર. અમે થોડી ટેકનિકલ ડિફિકલ્ટીઝ હેન્ડલ કરતા હતા, જેમ કે વોઇસ અને એ બધું અમે ચેક કરતા હતા. સો વી આર ઓન ટાઈમ, અને અમે 7:30ના નથી આવવાનું, અમે 7 વાગે 7:15 જ અમે આવી ગયા છે. તો ફર્સ્ટ ઓફ ઓલ, ગ્રીટિંગ્સ ટુ એવરીબડી ઓલ અક્રોસ ધ ગ્લોબ એન્ડ પીપલ હુ આર વોચિંગ અસ લાઈવ ઓન યુટ્યુબ એન્ડ ઓન ફેસબુક. વેલકમ વેલકમ. ટુડે ઇઝ અવર કોવિડ અવેરનેસ શો ડે 89. સો વી હેવ કમ્પ્લીટેડ 88 શોઝ ઓલરેડી એન્ડ સક્સેસફુલી, એન્ડ ટુડે ઇઝ અવર 89th શો. એન્ડ sometimes you know it is always like we always believe in medicine, but a lot of times there are certain remedies or there are certain aspects of medicine that is called extended medicine. Jem apne kena apro extended family em ho kais kam extended remedies very close to medicine, jo medicine jevu j kam kare, medicine jetlu j asar kare, right? So today we have celebrity doctors with us. We have Dr. Atul Shah and we have Dr. Rupa Shah, and they are going to talk on a very, very unique, special and different topic, which is about Indian flower remedy in COVID-19. A lot of times you may be wondering, what is Indian flower remedy? Did you know? Tamne khabar hati? Well, mane noti khabar. And that's the purpose ke we bring to you, we share with you, we update you very, very unique things on our show. And we bring very, very amazing doctors on our show. So today we have Dr. Prakash Moda along, like I said, with Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah. And we are going to talk about this flower medicine. But before that, let me tell you one thing. Do you guys remember that in Ramayana, and there was a time when Ram's brother, younger brother Lakshman, when Lakshman really felt sick and he became unconscious at that time, do you know what happened? Ram advised Hanumanji, which is Lord Hanuman, to go to some mountain and find a Sanjeevani. And what was that? We will tell you. So what is that Sanjeevani? That Sanjeevani is probably the flower, that is the medicine, which is actually not allopathic medicine, but it's coming long time back. Like varsho pehla there was Sanjeevani, but apne utha ke atyare kem nathi Sanjeevani. Wait a minute, there are treatments like that available, but just tamne khabar nathi, right? So we will talk about it further. I just gave a little example jo mara mind ma hatu, which I felt I should share with you guys. But before going there, let me start with quick introduction of Dr. Atul Shah. He is chairman of Om Himalaya Sanjeevani Essences. See, emni je company che emaj there is Sanjeevani. So I kind of, you know, related ke oh, maybe this is that Sanjeevani, but we'll ask him. But Dr. Atul K. Shah is a MD in allopathy and a radiologist from Bombay University. He has been a medical doctor for 47 years now, with wide experience in treatment and diagnostic methods in allopathy, as well as alternative and complementary therapies. He is also trained in MRI at different hospitals in USA. He was honorary assistant professor of radiology in Bombay University. He also has trained and he's having training in life cycle medicine from Harvard Medical School in Boston, USA. Well, that's very, very popular school. People dream about getting into Harvard Medical, and it's a real challenge to get admission there because the acceptance rate is probably in 0.59. Bojo cho. For last 37 years, he is practicing and making and researching Indian Himalayan flower remedies, which are featured in 5 international flower essence encyclopedias. He is researching bioenergy remedies, health hazard of electromagnetic population, environmental stress, bio nanotechnology, new air therapy, ફ્લાવર બડ સ્ટેમ સેલ એન્હેન્સર એન્ડ મેઝોથેરાપી. અને આવી તો બહુ જ બધી થેરાપીસ ભાઈ, એમને ખબર છે. વી વિલ આસ્ક એન્ડ વી વિલ ડિસ્કસ દેટ. ડ્યુ ટુ હિઝ એલોપેથિક બેકગ્રાઉન્ડ, હી હેઝ એન એડવાન્ટેજ એન્ડ પ્રિવિલેજ ઓફ ટ્રીટિંગ વેરિયસ કાઇન્ડ ઓફ પેશન્ટ્સ વિથ અ વેરાયટી ઓફ ડાયગ્નોસિસ એન્ડ સો કોલ્ડ, હે ડબલ કોટ્સમાં હું કહું ને તો, ઇનક્યોરેબલ ડિઝીઝીસ, કે જેનો કોઈ ક્યોર જ નથી, રાઈટ? But he is trying his best and he has been frequently invited along with his doctor wife to deliver guest lecture at various national and international conferences and seminars on alternative and complementary therapies. Together, they have opened a health center called Healing Temple in the heart of Mumbai city. Here, they offer consultation, therapies, products and workshop. He has delivered lectures at International Flower Remedies Essence Conferences in Australia, Canada, UK, USA, Germany, Italy, France, Spain, Switzerland. Oh my God, the list goes on and on and on. He has been featured in Bombay Times several times, also in many other newspapers and magazines. He was invited as a speaker in INMA International Conference at Cochin in 2017. He has been interviewed by Kiran Kher Show, Amul India Show, Better World TV Show in New York, Long Island Radio, National Radio in the US, Well Today, Radio Mirchi and Radio Midday. He was featured in the popular TV program called as Mano Yana Mano, ZTV and ITV, New York. Actually, I was also watching this show Mano Yana Mano because it's very interesting. His other interests are reading, music and cooking. But his ultimate dream in life is to bring about a major revolution through bioenergy remedies in healing human beings. Khali human beings aj nahi, animals and agriculture, by offering his groundbreaking research work in bioenergy nanotechnology. So this was a little bit about Dr. Atul Shah. Let me introduce his amazing wife. I'm the wife, Chana. It's backbone, right, of a husband. So let me introduce Dr. Rupa Shah now. Dr. Rupa Shah, MBBS, is trained in Western medicine in Bombay, developed a very keen interest in nature and healing therapies about 35 years back. While researching and treating patients, she came across the flower remedies. And on getting highly encouraging results from using flower remedies, she decided, along with Dr. Atul, to produce and research Indian flower remedies, as there was a lot of ancient philosophy behind Indian flower remedies. Jim is starting my kayuna program about Sanjeevani. Maybe there's a lot of Sanjeevani at their clinic. You know, I never know, but I'll visit when I go to Bombay. And she is also a pioneer in developing Indian flower remedies, which are featured again in all the several conferences, which I already told you. Jema, Dr. Atul is also featured. Also, she has been taken training on lifestyle medicine from Harvard Medical School at Boston, USA. She's treating all her patients with help of her flower energy remedies. This word energy is a keyword, and we will feature about and we will discuss about this energy keyword very specifically in our program. So it is energy remedy, plant-based diet and lifestyle, but also other complementary therapies, and is now lecturing all over the world on this particular subject. She has dedicated her entire life in researching about bioenergy remedies and is sharing her findings with everyone across the globe. She's also trained as allopathic physician, and she has helped, very important, she has helped her, I mean, this particular training in allopathic medicine has helped her to convince her colleagues and make them interested in using bioenergy remedies. She uses her allopathic knowledge in her research to present it more scientifically. Evo question tha ne, ke does this even work? Man apne emne puchisu. Finally, she helps people become khatta khatta, which is healthy, by reversing lifestyle-related diseases like diabetes, hypertension, obesity, high cholesterol, thyroid, my God, through her plant-based diet and lifestyle modifications. Well, again, she's also featured in Times of India, many famous magazines, but she was also on Star TV and Amul India show and radio shows in USA and India. And she has also been featured in Living Water and ITV. And that was her work on Living Water, which was featured in ITV in New York. She has written several books. One of her books is about dairy alternative book, and it has been translated in English, Hindi, and Gujarati. And she has also presented a lot of other publications and a lot of books on plant-based lifestyle. As a writer, she has contributed in magazines like Pharma Pulse, Femina. Hey, I used to read this when I was in India. Essence and Positive Health and lot more. Ama hu, jetlu introduction aapis, etlu ocho chhe amna vishe. And she has also her YouTube channel. We will ask her about it. She has been invited as a guest lecturer, like I said, in all these global countries across the globe. As an educator, she regularly conducts workshops. And here, I mean, in India, she's conducting the workshops at her own clinic. And the topics are really about healthy tools, reversing diseases, healthy weight loss, emotional freedom techniques. Which is wonderful, right? So we'll ask her ke bhai amare tamari workshop ma enroll thavu hoy to karvu khali doctors a allowed che evu thodi hoy. So we will talk to her. But even not just this, she has done a fabulous service to the society. She helped Sharan India in initial years to grow in Mumbai. Now she is core member of Ahimsa Paramo Dharma Group in Mumbai, which is organizing big festivals in Mumbai to promote Ahimsa, which is a way of living for health, animals, and environment. Her interest includes, obviously, yoga. I expected that. Traveling, reading, home gardening, and Gujarati literature. Her ultimate dream is to further her activities about her health center called Healing Temple by spreading awareness amongst masses about simple, gentle, harmless ways of healing and maintaining health. And what is her message? Her message is to heal. Double quotes ma kavto, to heal is to love. So I think she's very, very passionate. And now, I know tamne lagto satlu bodu introduction, but I to just thoduk che. This is just little bit. Baki hum book lakhi shaku emna vishe. Like I always tell, apna program ma je doctors aave che, book lakhi shakye badha vishe. So now it's time to invite our doctor, which is most a popular neurosurgeon, Dr. Prakash Modha on the show. Jene hu kau chu Bhishma Pitama of surgery. Surgeon ona surgeon, and who is also founder of Gokul Group of Hospitals in India. So he will come on the show as the tradition goes and share COVID statistics with us, like world statistics, USA, India, Rajkot, hey, emnu favorite hatu, Australia, and New Zealand. Hawe, apne kaise? So let me now invite Dr. Prakash Modha and also welcome Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah on our show. So welcome, Dr. Modha. Welcome.
Welcome, Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah.
Thank you.
I know them since my student life of neurosurgery. And he's my mentor and he helped me to get neurosurgery admission. So I love him and he's my very close friend in Mumbai. And that's why whenever I go to Mumbai, I cannot come without seeing him or at least telephoning. So is that my figure? And Dr. Atul Shah, whatever I said, I got no words to praise him. He's the jam of a person, marvelous human being. Apart from his good Himalayan flower remedies I have seen marvelous results of this thing. So, apart from them, let me talk about the COVID statistics now. Today also, no good news for US. It's very bad news that COVID new cases are 1,87,439 new cases and 2,210 deaths in USA. Coming to UK, it's 37,962 new cases and 114 new deaths. In India, it is 44,658 new cases and 496 new deaths. In Brazil, it is 31,024 new cases and 920 new deaths. Australia, 993 new cases, 2 deaths. But now I've shifted my favorite status from Australia to New Zealand. New Zealand today, yesterday, there were no new cases and no new deaths. Uh-huh. So New Zealand is the most favorite country of mine as far as corona is concerned. So now we'll say something about our Gujarat. In Gujarat, we have got total 16 new cases, 1/6 only, and no new death. Then Ahmedabad, Baroda, and Surat, they have got 3 new cases each. And very proudly saying that there are no new cases in Bhavnagar, Jamnagar, and Junagadh. So 0 new cases. Rajkot has got 1 new case. So Rajkot has got a little bit. But apart from that, so corona is receding in Gujarat. And about mucormycosis, no much good news. That means there is no news is good news. So, and about the vaccination, almost 10% of the total Indian population has been fully vaccinated. And so that is also a good news, and this is the way we can fight with the COVID. So with these remarks, I'll request my beloved Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah to start the discussion of Himalayan flower remedies. And in between, I will tell you something, what I've experienced from Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah. So let us start discussing, please.
Sure. Thank you, Dr. Moda.
And Dr. Rupa Shah.
Thank you for this.
So welcome, Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah. I think there is a presentation that you want to share. So I would like to first let you speak a few words, and then maybe we can start with the question answers.
Sure. So you will be surprised to know that we both are actually allopathic doctors. And my husband was in the best place in America as the Sloan Kettering Hospital doing his MRI. But something from within kept telling him that you have a larger purpose in life and you got to go back to India and start looking for it. And for me, I am an MBBS doctor, but as soon as I finished my studies, during my internship, I came to know about various natural therapies. And out of a lot of curiosity, I started, you know, visiting doctors, learning from them. And I realized that that is the missing link after learning all about allopathy. And then I was very sure that I wanted to have an integrated approach. That means you take the best of all the different pathies and then have an integrated approach in healing the patient. Finally, the patient has to be healed. His pain has to go. He has to feel comfortable. His disease has to become ease or comfort. So I came across a reference of flower remedies, and we started using a little bit of this flower remedies. So initially we remember there was a patient who had stammering, and he was a 30-year-old male and he was stammering a lot. So my husband started using some flower remedies, you know, studying his nature, that he was very impatient. He had fear of the unknown and he was very restless. So lack of confidence was also there. And he used some flower remedies, and this man at the age of 30, completely got cured of his stammering. And my husband was so, so taken by it that we have never learned this in a medical college. What is this? What is this system of healing? And someone as old as 30 also can, you know, overcome this kind of situation, which we thought, you know, is very difficult. So after that, there was no looking back. We started using lots of different flower remedies. And particularly, we are very interested in the flowers growing in India. Because in our country, from north to south, we have variety of flora and fauna. We got beautiful climate. Right in the north, you have Himalaya mountains. And then we also have a very tropical climate in the south. We have three seasons. Our country is very rich with variety, you know, of flowers. We call it as a very rich country from biodiversity point of view. So we started looking at various flowers growing in our own country. And like hibiscus or bougainvillea or ashoka or neem. I said, what this might be good for? Let's see. And that's how our journey began. We started making remedies from Indian flowers. And we understood that mind and body are always, you know, linked. Our emotions have very deep influence on our body. Diseases don't happen just like that. They have a very particular story. There's a reason. Our body is very transparent. Whatever happens to us happens because there's a cause, there's a story behind it. And when we do holistic approach, we treat always the mind and emotions along with body. And the flower remedies have the answer in treating mind and emotions. First, the body automatically gets better. So here you treat all the patients from the root cause of the disease. And so you are never dependent on medication, neither flower remedies. Once you are healed and the disease does not return. So this is the beauty of it. It never makes you dependent on remedies. It actually removes the very cause. It also causes mind and emotional transformation. So the healing is of a much higher quality. Healing, I always say that every disease comes for us with a lesson to learn. And the flower remedies are assisting in us learning this lesson and then overcoming the disease. This is the beauty of it. My husband was treating a lot of cancer patients initially. That was more than 30 years ago. And he found that one of his leukemia patients who was on his last hour and he was in the hospital, doctors, everyone had given up. And that time he just thought, what is the harm? Let's just try. And he just said, this is holy water, you know, please give it to him. And to his surprise, that within 2 hours, the patient became conscious and his blood levels, you know, leukemia patient, all the numbers improved. Within few weeks, he was discharged from the hospital. And then he lived after that for a few years. And he did not die of cancer, but he died of some other disease. But what is the interesting part that as till you breathe, the hope is there and you never give up. And if the right remedies come, who knows, you know, the person can come back to life and can live a very good life. After this, our inspiration has continued that this is something the world has to know. We have to tell, we have to share that this is a system of healing which is harmless, which is gentle, which is very fast, and which is very effective, and it's very cost effective as well. So now I'll stop talking. I must let him speak.
Yeah, I told you that ladies first, and I will have a very little chance to talk. Okay. Hi, guys. How are you? Let me tell you first that first principle in our therapy is that safety part of it. Is the remedy safe or not? Okay. So that is first thing that it is. There is no known side effect of this remedy in last 38 years of my practice. Okay. I'm a medical doctor for last 48 years, but I have not seen any adverse effects, side effects, or untoward effects. Another thing is that it is complementary to other therapy. It can be used as an alternative to this or complementary. So there is no ego clash, you know, that only my therapy works. And so that's in short about it. The Indian flower remedies work on not only on physical, I mean, emotional and mental, but it works on physical level also. And it goes, our research is right up to epigenetics level. So some doctors who are here on this, you will be surprised that we work on epigenes also and treat our patients like that. And to start again with that Indian flower remedies, we started, it's a basically energy-based remedy and not chemical-based remedy. So if you do analysis of these remedies, you find nothing except for a base substance. So base substance may be only water or a sugar pills or some glucose powder, something like that. So there is nothing. And beyond that, now our latest research work is also on the Fogger therapy and laser therapy, where there is no actual something substance that you can think of. So all these things are there, and we are combining the our Ayurvedic knowledge, also Chinese medicine, what is called traditional Chinese medicine principles, not the traditional Chinese medicine, but traditional Chinese medicine principles we are using it. Okay, so everything put together, so meridian remedies, chakra remedies, all these things we have got it. And Ishita, you want to know about it, then we will talk about how we make the flower remedies. And
yes, so first of all, I want to thank you both for giving a little bit of context to our audience. I spoke a lot, but it helps to build that one-on-one connection when the doctors talk, right? So there were a couple of comments, bring the doctors on the show. So I was like, yes, let's start. But my question is about what are these flower remedies? So I think we'll start with this question, which is, what are flower remedies? Can you explain in detail, are there any side effects of this remedy? And can you explain about bioenergy remedies and how do you actually make it?
Okay. First, let me tell you, as I told you, that there is it's an energy-based remedy, and we transfer the energy of the flowers. When I say flower, not necessarily flower only. It may be bud, it may be stem, it may be roots, it may be leaves. Okay. So, for example, tulsi leaves are more healing proper. So we will transfer the energy of tulsi leaves. Okay. So in short, we are taking all parts of the flower, but without damaging, without cutting it. We have developed an apparatus, which I'll show you the video film now. So you can see, and then we'll talk more about it, that how we make. There are two methods.
Sure.
You can see this. So there is a spiritual aspect also in this.
The process of preparing remedies from flowers begins with a special prayer ceremony offered to the flowering tree from which energy is to be beauty. The process of preparing remedies from flowers begins with a special prayer ceremony offered to the flowering tree from which energy is to be tapped. The healing energies of flowers are tapped and then transferred to water. No flowers are cut or destroyed in the preparation, thereby maintaining eco-balance. Prayers are once again offered to the tree as part of thanksgiving at the end of the process. Along with flowers, gemstones and herbs are also used as energy sources, and a similar remedy preparation process is followed for them also. Energy transfer is also accomplished by using a very special energy transfer device where no part of the flower directly comes in contact with water used for the remedy preparation. Energy healing remedies made in water as a carrier are called as energy essences remedies. It has only the energetic imprint of flower, gem, or herb. In fact, there is no change in the chemical composition of water. Water is simply energized with the energies and vibrations of the flower, gemstones, or herbs through a special process.
Wonderful. This was really great. Let me stop here for a moment and ask Dr. Modha if he has comments. What do you think, Dr. Modha? Have you seen this before?
Yeah, I have seen it and I have experienced it also. So I'll tell you one example. One day we were in Mumbai and in Rajkot also. We went for a dinner and there was onion, cut onions in the salad, you know. So I ate onions, take first bite with the onion lying on the dish. So I take it. And as usual, onion taste was pungent and I accept it because I was knowing that this will be the test. Then he put some device under the plate. And then he asked me to taste the onion.
Okay. Only 10 seconds.
How much?
10 seconds. We put it under the test. Yeah.
And what happened? What happened then after 10 seconds?
The pungent taste of the onion was changed. And similar thing, I have experiences. The change of taste of water. So similarly, you drink a water simply, then you put a device under the glass. You drink that water also, you feel difference. So that is what my friend Dr. Atul Shah is doing. And that is I am the witness of. So he's doing a great job, but unfortunately, in our country, people do not accept it. They say la jadugar se ram se tem te na. But in reality, it is a result of his hard work and research which has produced this. But people do not understand the reality. And that's why I have to bring him on the show. That people should know this is a hero. This our friend who is a marvelous healing doctor, I should say. And they should recognize it. And they should take his advantage as much as they can. So that is why I brought him in our show. And he will tell you, sometimes you go to Mumbai, he will show you everything. This and you will experience it.
Definitely. But I had one question, Dr. Modha. When I was reading the bio, it said that, right, he is a chairman, like Dr. Atul Shah is a chairman of Om Himalaya Sanjeevani Essences Private Limited. So I was wondering that he has Om, then he has Himalaya and also Sanjeevani. How did these three came up together and then you brought Essence? Thoru, if you can, I know this is a side question, but I'm very curious to know and I think our listeners would be curious as well.
Yeah. Atul bhai, please reply.
One thing, Rupa will tell more, but one thing I'll tell you, every word has got its own energy, okay? So just speaking the word Om itself is releasing a lot of energy. So many people experience this by using the word. I'm putting the spelling as A-U-M and not O-M. It's Om, okay? So A-U-M is the spelling that we use it, okay? But you can use O-M also. But this is important that every word, every sound that you are releasing, that is a particular frequency in that. And that particular frequency will help to heal your body. So that word Om was there. Then of course, we used to take a lot of remedies from. Basically, let me tell you, this flower remedies, when we use it, we don't use garden flowers. Okay. We don't grow also. Everything is in nature, whichever is there in the forest, that only we use it. And the best thing about our therapy is that we are not destroying the nature, we are not cutting the flowers, we leave it there, we are just taking the energy of that flower and the flowers remains on the plant. Okay, so there is an ecological balance also. So that is one of the best part of it. And there is no carbon imprint in this. So it's very simple. And Rupa will tell more about Sanjeevani part of it.
Yes. So, you said about Sanjeevani and Hanumanji, the story.
Yeah.
So I wanted to say that there's a particular flower, we call it as Akdo in Gujarati. It is also called as swellowwort. It's a little purple color flower which opens like that. It's also called as crown flower. So this particular flower, the leaves are, you know, made into a garland, and also the mala is offered to Lord Hanuman on every Saturday. Now there are, the flowers have their deities associated with it, and the very interesting part is that if, you know, somebody is very fearful, we say, "Arre Hanuman ji ko yaad karo," you know, you remember Hanuman ji, and then you do your Hanuman Chalisa, then your fears will go away. So the healing energy of that flower associated with that deity is that of courage. For a fearful child, we give the flower remedy from that swellowwort or crown flower. So every flower also has a complete association with the deity. We call it as Vruksha Devta or Vruksha Devi. And the divine energy from these devas is also there in the flower. And when we take the flower remedies, we get exactly the same mental and emotional quality of that particular deva. So this is our sacred science. We don't tell all this information to everybody. But there is also a very interesting thing. You know, Sanskrit names are exactly according to the healing quality of the flower. So for example, there is Ashok. Ashok in Sanskrit, thus Ashok flowers are beautiful orange color blossoms, that is around the month of March, April. Ashok means without grief. And when Sita sat in Ashoka 1 and she was grieving, she sat under an Ashoka tree, and her grief and her depression was taken care by the tree and by the flowers. In modern times, when we make the flower remedy from the Ashok, it's for depression. Anyone who has gone through a lot of sadness in life is very depressed, very lost. We give them the Ashoka flower remedy. So this is how, you know, our ancestors knew. There is a science, there's a book called as Pushpa Ayurveda. There's a reference in the Jain literature. There were 18,000 different flowers were researched because Jains believed in ahimsa, in compassion, in not destroying any animals. So they always practice this Pushpa Chikitsa, Pushpa Ayurveda. So this is our ancient science only. We just came to know a bit later that, oh my goodness, all this is already there. We were using it. It's only revival of the same thing. It's a branch of Ayurveda, and it was very well practiced by the Jain Acharyas. So there's very lot of fascinating stories, but I think one of the biggest stories that we have is regeneration of the organs and tissues and nail and skin tissues, and prevention of gangrene, and regeneration of some nerves and muscles and joint repair, and all these are very, very fascinating. These are the new prospects of this flower remedies. Right now we are also using it for animals. So someone will say that, "Arre, you know, aapne aise, you know, you just make people drink water and it must be a placebo effect." So we would like to say that it's not a placebo effect, because when you give it to the animals, animals are very fast in healing. Within first dose itself, you know, they start responding. Animal doesn't know that what medicine was given. So there is no question of placebo. There is no mind. Animals respond, and within few days they get better. Then very small babies, you know, newborn babies or 1 year old infant, baby doesn't know what remedies are given. There is no auto suggestion. So there is no placebo effect, because they get well so fast. So there are also a lot of the research is happening in Germany, and there's also a Japanese scientist, Emoto. He has done a lot of research in the water, storing the memory of the flower and water crystal patterns. And in Germany, they took the picture of every drop, and then they found exact pattern of that particular flower that was in it. That proves the point that water stores the information. So there's a lot of work going on all over the world. Lots of, there is an encyclopedia from all over the world describing 2,000 different flowers now. So know that from India, we represent our Indian flowers are listed in the encyclopedia.
And The best part is that we both are allopathic trained medical doctors. Okay, so there may be a few people who are making flower remedies, not necessarily they're allopathic trained medics. So we keep in mind about the allopathic science. Okay, so we know what is the function of the kidney, what is the function of the liver, and where it is and how to treat that. So a lot of things are there because of our allopathic experience. So it's not just something that you can rule out that no, this doesn't work, you know, like that.
Yes.
That Rupa said that, you know, about the animal's placebo effect, I can tell you we have treated 1 day old child, not one, but quite a few, that when they have a diarrhea problem or they have a colicky problem, we treat and in, just I'm tapping up, in few seconds, he starts getting the healing. The child stops crying also. So we know for certain. Now, child doesn't know it is a allopathic medicine or homeopathic medicine, natural medicine, our remedies. Okay. 1 day old, they have started responding to it.
So this placebo effect is also used in pets, in humans, in kids. Everybody you have treated with this. And I think Dr. Moda has a comment or question.
Yeah, I have a question, Atul Bhai. You extract the energy from the flower. Which device? That device is made up of what? And what is it?
Yeah, so you see the video again. You will see later on your video. There is a glass apparatus. And that the flower was just put into that glass apparatus. Water was dropping from top. And then there was something like spiral. And then was getting collected. Same water recirculated like this. This was our original method. Then the question comes that because water is touching the flower, maybe some chemical is going from the flower into the water. So we have developed, you saw that another one, which is a copper plate. It's a very special copper plate, which has got ability to draw the energy from the flower. Now, two important things. There are many flower remedies in the world, but what we are doing is that we are not only using the healing property of the flower, but the living energy. Because we are not cutting the continuous, the living energy of the flower is also, we are transferring into our base substance. It's connected with the wire and then collected them. That is what my video was showing. So, no, there is, and I said that there is no connection of directly the flower and the water. You know, they're both separate. It's just connected with our special device that we have developed of our own. Okay. Yeah.
Yes, and Dr. Moda. Sorry.
One more question is about that device. You have shown just like glass, some kitchen material. You could keep it under the glass. That was not a copper. But that
No. I let me explain. If you see the video, we will.
Yeah, you can show us if you have. You know.
No. The video on which Keshav got a plate taken. Machine call.
I can also show the device if you want. The device has a. Washer.
Dr. Moda, you are mixing two things. This is the what I was telling you about the how to make the flower remedies. The device you were talking, okay, that device was a disc, small disc, which was emitting the energy from the device through the table, through the plate, into your food. And that's why it was modifying it. So we have made a lot of devices like that. Uh-huh. Okay. Now this is what in the video I had shown, or you can see later on again. That it was connected with the is a very special plate, okay, and so it was connected to the wire and through the small box machine. It was the energy was transferring to that, and from there it was going into the water. Only the energy was going, nothing physical substance like that. I mean, nothing chemical substance going into it. Okay, so two things are different. If you want, you can rerun at the end this video, so you will be able to see it.
We are actually getting a question from our live viewers. that okay. Are you treating cancer patients? So I want you guys to answer that, you know. Shalini is asking this on YouTube.
Cancer patients, are you treating cancer?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. In fact, in my career, first patient was of cancer patient only. No, not first, second patient. Second was that was in that cancer hospital where I went there and I treated. And
so over the years, we do treat many cancer patients. It is an integrated approach. So they may be going through surgery, chemo and radio as usual, but we support their body. We reduce the side effects of chemotherapy and we also reduce the side effects of radiation. So the patient has better chances of survival, putting up with all the treatment is so harsh in cancer. Even the mentally and emotionally patient is so shattered. So we help with the flower remedies to even become stronger. And with all these measures, we have still seen some of the patients whom we thought are going to go off in just a month or few weeks. They have survived sometimes 2 years, 3 years.
I got one patient who survived for 14 years. Okay, 14 years. And then the patient had come in a grade 4A stage of lymphoma. Okay, and but I had, even I never expected that this patient will survive so well, but she did so well. And I will tell you also that these are something called as a patches. I can show you like this. These are basically people who do acupuncture, they use it for this purpose. One small square from this, but we have converted it, we put our flower remedies into it, and then we put it over the chemotherapy bottles, okay, it will modify the and decrease the side effect of all the chemotherapy, okay. After the radiation, if they have developed, because their aura is damaged, when you give the radiation, their aura is damaged. We need to treat aura also. So if we give this spray, this is the spray bottle like this, okay. So we spray it before and after the chemo, radiotherapy, and patients feel lot better. Okay, so then of course, as I told you, one of the best thing about this flower remedy, everybody will think that how long it will take.
If so,
how long will it take? Yeah, you ask the question.
Yeah, before that, I think one more question we can take, which is, can you explain what is this holistic approach to healing?
See, we treat body as a whole. So I tell you that, for example, emotions. The fear goes to the kidney. Okay? Anger goes to the liver.
Uh-huh.
So if your anger is suppressed, then your liver is affected. If your fear is, there are two fear. One is the known fear. Another is called as a subconscious fear. Okay? So if we treat that part of it, okay, then you can treat many diseases related to kidney, and the kidney is also connected to lungs. Okay, that is a Chinese way of thinking it. So then you can treat asthma also. Kidney is also related to ear, deafness. Okay, so we will be able to treat that part also. And the liver is connected to the eyes. So if somebody has got eye problem, and if I take the history, that it is a suppressed anger, which is then we'll be able to treat it. Just by treating the anger will treat the liver part of it. Liver will be connected to the eyes. So this is something, this is called holistic approach. You know, like emotions are also there in the gallbladder. Yes. So if we treat somebody who's depressed and all those things, there is antipsychotic medicine, everything. We respect allopathic approach, we don't say, but we can also reduce this by using this gallbladder meridian remedy. Okay, so there are a lot of flowers and gem remedy which we use it, mix it and make a combo and give it to our patients, so that the depression, their mood elevation is instant. Sometimes mood elevation is like in less than 10 minutes or like that. Okay,
excellent Dr. So the next question, that is, how fast? You said instant, right? Instant Abhijit effect. Is that true? Instantly, yeah, the patient feels it.
Let me share with you today's example.
Yeah.
I was upset with one mechanic who would come and check my gas cylinder and everything, pipes and all. So in past there was somebody who had come and done some wrong thing. So he had come to do the checking part of it, and I was with all the negative things that this guy is also the same guy, you know. But he did his job and he said that, "Are you doctor?" I said, "Yes." She said, "I have got knee joint problem." So I said, "Okay, you see me at around 1 o'clock in the afternoon." And he came here, and to his surprise, he was suffering from knee joint arthritis for last almost 1.5 to 2 years. Okay. And I treated with flower and an instant result, instant. This is something unbelievable, but we have done a lot of things. This is called as a neo air therapy, which is neo energy air therapy. So it's a restructured air with our technology. This is also the laser, which is again a restructured laser. So you can see the different lights are there. And so we can treat this also. So flower remedy has been, energy part is extended into many things in the form of spray or in the form of what we call, this is a fogger. Just take it like this, 5 times, breathe it through the mouth 5 times, and that's all. Your sore throat and nasal block will go just in less than 2-3 minutes, you know, like that sometimes.
Wonderful. So
I don't say 100% for everything, but the success rate is pretty high. It's about 70 to 80% straight. Okay, like that.
Excellent. So next question I have is, can you give us how our immune system can be strengthened? And then we'll take COVID questions.
Sure. So, you know, ideally our immune system is our resistance, our strength to remain where we are, very strong, disease-free, ability to identify our enemies and eliminate them, not let them enter or destroy us. That's our immune system. So immune system has the ability to recognize what belongs to the self and what doesn't belong to the self. Now, ideally, Ishita, we all would dream of living in the company of nature, tall trees, mountains, birds, water, sunshine, moon, you know, 5 elements, natural fragrance, nature's food, and then we would be in harmony as part of the nature. But unfortunately, we have come very far, and now we are surrounded by so many gadgets. There are like 2-3 cell phones, there are laptops, there are iPads, there's Wi-Fi. We are constantly bombarded with so much of chemical pollution, air pollution, water pollution, also the pollution in our thinking, in our emotions. Because of all these things, our immune system has weakened. We are even eating food which is, you know, full of pesticides. So now how do we gather our strength? It's through various flower remedy formulae. Apart from having a healthy lifestyle, like yoga, meditations, do not sacrifice your sleeping hours, eat mostly healthy food which is organic. All these, apart from that, emotionally, feeling calm, positive, releasing and let go, forgiveness, and the nature's flower remedies. The various formula that we have, one of the most popular formula is immunity booster. We just inspire our patients to start taking the drops of this. That's what we've done through the COVID also. Mm-hmm. That best thing would be to strengthen your immune system. Reduce our susceptibility. Because how long can we go on wearing masks, or isolating, or, you know, always washing our hands. And we know that as a doctor also, we are exposed to this all the time. So the best thing is to be not suitable to any pathogenic viruses or bacteria. Do not provide such environment and become so healthy that even if something comes closer, it is eliminated by a very alert immune system. This is our aim, and this is what we keep inspiring everyone to keep your immune system very strong. Do not be afraid of disease. Be very strong, positive, that you can look after yourself. This is how we do it.
Most of the time, we are successful in treating by boosting the immunity of life. Particularly even for the kids, you know, we get some wonderful results. Kids who are getting a frequent cold and diarrhea and fever problem, we just boosted their immune system, and they are no earlier. They were in a year they will get admitted in hospital for three to four times. Now not once also.
Wonderful. So this,
yeah. So this is what again I'm saying. It's not 100% for everything, but the success rate is pretty high. Sometimes 80, 85, 90% also in the immunity booster, you know, like that. Another thing, I mean, particularly COVID, COVID divided now into three parts. One is that what you rightly say, immunity. Boost up your immunity so that you can protect yourself. Okay, one. Second thing is treating actual COVID patients, symptomatic or asymptomatic. Both are treated at a time. And the third is very important, is that post-COVID, long COVID, you know, this is a very big problem. And lot of things are happening, right from hair fall, you know,
exactly. Very
anxiety, psychological level, disturbed sleep, insomnia, then the early development of cataract, middle ear infection, okay, gingivitis and glossitis, means inflammation of the tongue and the gums, okay, then the thyroid problem, again, then indigestion, irritable bowel disease, autoimmune diseases. In autoimmune disease, I would put diabetes also, hypertension, that is called as a metabolic syndrome, you know. So these common things, even putting on weight, obesity, okay, urinary tract infection, very, very important. You'll be surprised that you'll take what it has to do with the COVID. And last but not least is myocarditis, all the blood clots formation in the brain or in the heart, coronary arteries or carotid arteries. You know, this is very important and we are treating them successfully. Again, success is pretty high, almost like 85% of the people get instant relief. Okay.
So,
we also reduce the lung fibrosis during the post-COVID. If they develop the lung fibrosis, at the during the COVID treatment only, we give them some remedy. So it is reducing the chance of lung fibrosis.
So the question that I have is, how do you handle if someone gets infected?
Yeah, if they contact us, we just give them the remedies. But there are certain regulations which prevent certain hospitals do not allow these remedies. So in that case, we once the patient is out, or those who have not got admitted, okay, and they take treatment only in-house, we treat them, you know, that way, with flower remedies. With fogger, as I told you, this is a wonderful thing. This
one, yeah. Fogger. Yeah.
Very, and no smell, nothing like that. It just do it like this and that's all. You do it 5 to 6 times during your COVID infection and that's all. Another thing I wanted to tell you was that the placebo effect, what you were telling about.
Yes.
Seeds of the brinjal or the, yeah, and these are the seeds of Karela. So we treat with our flower remedies and then the growth is very, very high and much better. And there is not much of pest attack on these plants, you know, like that. So plant doesn't know, the seed doesn't know it's a flower remedy, Manji. But the simplest way to know, if you want to know that flower remedy is working, is that just sprouts. In 2 or 3 days, you will come to know, put the drops of our flower remedy, the sprouts will be so big and so nice, you know. And the protein part of that is also great. So the digestion is better of this protein.
Okay. So, Dr. Atul, I think a lot of people have these questions who are even watching us live. Okay, what about the side effects of vaccine? Can you also help if somebody is getting that?
I don't make any claims for that there is a side effect because it's a controversial subject. But whatever we see here, in some reports we saw here in India, yet the 25% of the, just day before yesterday's paper, newspaper, they said that 25% of the people do get post-vaccine problem. So I don't go into number figure like that. If at all they have got post-vaccine problem, we treat them with these remedies without any side effect, any adverse effect like that. Yeah, it's absolutely fantastic, you know. Yeah.
Yes, yes. Dr. Moja comments about any side effects.
Yeah, yeah. There are lots of side effects sometimes. Simple headache, feverishness, body ache. So that myalgic pain, muscle pain, huh, all will probably go with the help of our simple allopathic medicine. But as per Dr. Atul says, they can relieve with the flower remedies also.
Excellent. So next question, which is, do you teach other therapists about the system of healing? If somebody wants to learn.
Yeah, if they are ready, then we are ready to teach.
We have done many workshops in Europe and America also, teaching other therapists how to use each of these flower remedies.
Definitely. Particularly in Switzerland, Italy, Germany, Spain, we have done a lot of these things. In Malaysia also, I have gone there and we have treated patients and shown the doctors how to treat with the Indian flower remedies particularly.
Excellent. So I think this is the important question, which is, where can we find more information about your work, your website, your social media handles, YouTube, anything that you can pass on to our listeners?
So we have a website on the name of our company, that is www.omhimalaya, that is A-U-M, omhimalaya.com. We are also having a YouTube channel on the name of Healing Temple. So in healing, the G is not there. But otherwise also, if you look for us as Dr. Atul and Dr. Rupa Shah, Mumbai Flower Remedies, in Google, you should be able to find us with all our cell numbers, our location. Our Healing Temple is also there on Google Map location with lots of people who have written their testimonials also.
I'll repeat once more that it is heal in and not healing.
Heal in. Okay.
Yeah. Healing Temple. Okay.
Particularly, YouTube has a lot of those videos on various subjects that people might be interested in. So it's worth going through the videos.
And then we have not talked something about, apart from that, as I told you, that psychological problem post-COVID or post-vaccination, if they develop, there are wonderful remedies. Plus, there are very good remedies for the pediatrics, you know.
Yes.
From autism to hyperactive, or for the kids who are very fearful, or who has got fear of examination, or middle-aged people who are going for an interview and they want to take some booster remedies. Okay, these are some flower remedies. It works instantly. They can just take the drops, few drops, and then go for an interview or for exam. I've got a lot of patients, you know, kids particularly appearing for the, in India, there is called 10th and 12th. Okay, so these are important years for their career. And we have given them these remedies. And a child who was getting only 55% of score got, you know, 95% in 2 years' time. Okay. So these are something which we see a lot of positive, favorable results. I would also tell Dr. Moda that if you use these flower remedies before operation, the aura of the patient, if you change it, you will have a tremendous success post-operative. The healing will be much more, it will be better healing, and the patients feel confident about it. It will help you also, that the patient is cooperative in that. So this is what my feeling is, that the surgeons can try this therapy if they are open to this.
Alternative approach. Yes.
He has written a comment that who treated him. The entire family was down with COVID and treated entire family just at home.
So with the laser, that was my question too, that how were you able to treat Anil Agarwal and his family with laser, with flower and laser, very curious.
Yeah. So the laser was an instant relief that they could get it. And then the remedies were sent later on. Because he is staying far away in Rajasthan, which is little remote place. So it takes about 4 to 5 days to send the remedies. So before that, 5 days was a too long time for them to get. But I did it with laser. I treated one patient in Africa also. She came from London to Africa and she got COVID. And the place where she was saying was a remote place, she said it takes about 2 hours to reach to go for a COVID test also. I treated her only with laser remedy and nothing else, no other remedies. Even and some fantastic results, she recovered only in 7 days time, 7 days only.
Dr. Mota has some question or comment.
Atul bhai, I want to know from the flower remedies, is there any particular flower is used for the particular remedies of the disease?
Yeah. I mean, usually, initially we made only 51 flower remedy, single flower remedy. So now let me tell you one thing. The lotus flower, Rupa is a master in that. I remember when we went after our marriage, first time to Australia, and we were giving talk. And she said, I will talk on lotus flower remedy. And I was just wondering, in 1 hour's time, how you are going to keep the crowd, as I said. And she talked so well, and very interesting part of it that before that, we had not sold more than one bottle of our flower remedies. And after our lecture, we had no time to take lunch or dinner, could not sleep also because so much of order was there of the flower remedies. So coming to the point that lotus is one of the very important flower. It can be used in many diseases. So we are not using one flower only for one thing. We make combinations of flower remedies, gem remedies also, and a few herbs remedy. Only herbs essences, not the energy essences, not the... And this has nothing to do with aromatherapy. Just please don't make mistake that flower remedies and aromatherapy, they are no way similar. Aromatherapy is essential oils and they have got smell, and our flower remedies have got no smell, no taste, nothing like that. So just for your information. Yeah. So we use flowers for different and combinations are made. It's not one. Once upon a time we were using only one and we had only 10% effect. Now we have got 80-85% effect because we are using a lot of combinations of flower remedies.
We are getting a lot of comments and I'm not able to, you know, post all the comments, but I'd like to share one of this comment, which is very true. So Tushar Modha is telling us that very insightful and informative session, but we need general awareness too, because this is helping so many patients. So just
correct.
Right?
Absolutely. We need to create awareness, and that's the reason why we are now going to have a flower remedy course. Those who know who want to learn about flower remedies, we are going to very soon announce online course of flower remedies. Just start, create the awareness, learn about it. There are so many questions, so many things to answer. But at least let us begin. So we have just designed the course. It will be ready in 2 weeks' time. Then we will announce. So from anywhere in the world, you can learn about flower remedies. Just the basic.
Basically.
Yeah, Indian flower remedies.
Excellent. And then if let's say I enroll for it, would I get certified flower practitioner or some certification once I take your course?
Yes, there are levels in it. First we will do basic, then there will be intermediate, and then there will be advanced. And we inspire people to do certain case studies, report them, and then we can take it further. Definitely. That's what we've been doing all these years.
In fact, let me tell you that the confidence we developed more because we could treat some doctors who are MD or MS, you know, anesthetist something, you know, they were very serious with COVID patient. And one of the doctor, he called me at 4 o'clock in the morning and he was breathless and he just told me, doctor, can you help me? Can you help me? That's all he could speak. And he was on, you know, like very breathless with COVID. He was anesthetist, and trust me, is absolute. Today only he was talking to me I think I don't mind because he, I think he's very open to it. He's Dr. Jagannath from Mysore. He's an anesthetist. And he had, not only that, before that he had a brain atrophy. Now Dr. Moda is going to open your eyes more and more, right? Your eyebrows are going to go up, okay? And this guy, you should ask him, you know, he will tell you that how he recovered. He was not able to drive car. He had given up. He has given up the anesthesia, anesthesiology, you know, like he's no more practicing. But after our treatment, he's able to drive car. He was doing everything and memory has come back, everything. And he's now gone into alternative stuff, you know, complementary medicine. Today only he was talking to me about this therapy. So there are many people, I have treated them, you know, medical doctors particularly, and they have been very much benefited. Dr. Moda, you remember that I had treated one patient with torticollis and cervical spondylitis in Rajkot, you know?
I do, yeah.
Yeah, and many patients that day, you saw almost like 78 patients we treated that day. One man show, you know?
Oh my God.
We treated neo energy air therapy. That is a different subject. We will talk sometimes in future.
Sure.
We'll bring it again.
Yeah. But
after 2 weeks or so,
we will talk about the pain management. That will be a great thing, you know, because these are the something which is hardly any invasive procedure is there, you know, nothing going. Yeah.
Please answer, Dr. Yes. Mr. Jyoti. Can you get this medicine in Pune?
In Pune. She is asking. So,
the remedies are only available through our center in Mumbai and we courier it all over the world. And we also do online consultations if required and then we courier the remedies. But it's only available in my center, from my center. They are freshly prepared. We don't keep them always ready in stock or something. Once you place the order, then we courier it to you. You can visit our website and see the list of all different kinds of formula we have. And lots of information will be there. And as I said, just do watch our videos. That has a lot of information.
And just for your information, it may be like that, that the remedies will be available in Switzerland, Italy, Germany. You can buy there and get in India.
Yes.
That's what they
think. I want to have an agency of this. All distributed, see.
Sure.
So I am just flashing the comments, which we are still getting a lot of comments. Dr. Anil has mentioned very informative session. Then also Anil Agarwal said, my mother's got relief in 10 minutes in COVID with laser.
Yes. Yeah, that was on. She was having severe backache, and he was worried most, not for himself, well, not for wife, not for kids, but for the mother. She was the last in that COVID who got infected, and she had a severe backache. After 10 minutes, she said, I don't think I have got anything, you know, like that. That was her response, you know, like that.
And I think Dr. Jagannath, who is an anesthesiologist, he's also watching your show right now. So he's telling, hey, doctor, it's me.
Great. Yeah.
Awesome.
And we
what
have...
What is inspiring is, you know, have a complementary approach, integrated approach.
Yes.
Let us take best of whatever is available from whichever direction.
Yeah.
There's nothing superior or inferior, but keep ourselves open, a mind open to new knowledge. And just integrate them, you know, into our regular practice.
So it is called as a fusion therapy. When in my about 15 years back, I used this word, fusion therapy. You fuse this therapy, and let's work together. Let the patient get benefit of it. No ego. We don't have any ego. And so still we are using the word complementary, but there are a lot of things which is alternative also. But we don't want to keep that thing. We want to have a complementary approach, fusion therapy. That's what I feel it will work well with it. And the best part is that it doesn't clash with each other. That's why it can work very well.
So I think one question that a lot of listeners would ask is, they are wondering if there is any allergy due to aroma or any known case so far, like sneezing or breathing.
Okay, very good question. I did tell before that there is no aroma in our therapy. First thing, no smell at all, no taste at all. It is water based, or if it is sweet based, you know, then it is that sweet taste, nothing beyond that. Okay, so, and there is no question of getting the, this Fogger therapy also does not cause any sneezing or anything like that. So safe it is. Okay, so
wonderful.
No, yeah, no no allergies. Most that's what I would use the word, keep 1% for the bot, and 99% I can tell you that this is one of the safest way of treating the patients.
Already, I think we already have some distributors and we have somebody who already wants to take your course. A lot of listeners are watching live. Looks like you are pretty popular already. So excellent session. Yeah.
He is very popular man. And he is doing a good service to the humanity and service to our society. So we appreciate Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah both.
And thank you.
We are much grateful that you have come to our show and enlighten our viewers about the alternative therapy and sometimes the treatment for the various diseases. And as you saw, the comments we have received is immense, and that shows its popularity. So there is no doubt about it. And we wish that we will call Dr. Atul Shah and Dr. Rupa Shah once again after 2 weeks or so. Atul bhai, we want to complete our 100 shows of COVID.
So this the 100th
show, and tomorrow is 19th show. So once that 100 shows is over, we will again start our reshuffling, and then in that program we will call you again. But
yeah,
it is really interesting, eye-opening things, and it's good and useful to the common people. And even to the doctors as well.
Yes.
So one should keep the open mind, open heart, open mind to take advantage of these beautiful flower remedies. And I'm happy to announce that he's doing this job since last 37 years. So we congratulate to this young, energetic couple. And we pray God that it should continue, they should continue it, and give advantage.
Lot of healing.
What I want to tell you is give some thing to the society as we get something from the God. So see, give, and that is the, what I should say is, as Rupa says, that ahimsa paramo dharma is like that. If you have some knowledge, give it to someone, it will increase. You know, it will increase the knowledge. And there is what I'm saying. Nachorahariyam nachabhatrubhajyam nachabharakar. Vaya krute vardhate eva nityam vidya dhanam sarva dhanam prakar.
Wow.
Chor chori kari shakta nathi. Bhaiyo bhag padvi shakta nathi. આનું કોઈ વજન લાગતું નથી. અને જે ધન વાપરવાથી હંમેશા વધે છે એવું વિદ્યારૂપી ધન સર્વ ધનોમાં શ્રેષ્ઠ છે. એટલે ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટ યોર નોલેજ, પ્લીઝ ડિસ્ટ્રીબ્યુટ નોલેજ ફોર ધ હેલ્પ ઓફ અ હ્યુમન બિંગ ઓર હ્યુમન મેનકાઇન્ડ. સો ધીસ ઇઝ માય રિક્વેસ્ટ. વિથ ધીસ થિંગ વીલ એન્ડ ધ શો. એન્ડ આઈ અગેન કોંગ્રેચ્યુલેટ ડોક્ટર અતુલ શાહ એન્ડ ડોક્ટર રૂપક શાહ, એન્ડ આઈ એમ મચ ઓબ્લાઇજ that you have enlightened our viewers. And in future also, please do come on our show as and when we'll request you.
Likewise.
So, Mona and Dr. Mirchita, Ishita and Mirchita.
I am not doctor, I am engineer by the way. Software engineer.
Dr. Mona and Mirchita. Yes. Okay. Thank you very much for giving me opportunity and my wife this opportunity. We are able to give awareness through your show, and I'm very, very happy that you have given us such a wonderful platform.
We will call you back again. And tomorrow, Dr. Modha, we have a doctor from Australia. But I'll let Dr. Rupa also comment, closing comments, and then we'll say who is coming tomorrow.
Yeah, so I just wanted to say very quickly that just as I said before, keep your minds and hearts open, and you will receive new knowledge. And this is also this last thing, that there were two roads diverge in the wood, and I took the one which was less traveled by. We both took a path which was less traveled by, and that has made the difference. And I'm very happy. Thank you very much.
Correct, and I totally agree with you. Absolutely correct.
Yes, we need more awareness for sure. So we will call you again. Thank you so much. And tomorrow we have Dr. Krunal from Australia, who is going to share with us that Australia ma COVID ni su situation che and how he is doing emergency trauma management of patients coming in ICU, because he is working as an emergency doctor over there. So that is our.
So we'll welcome Dr. Krunal. And we'll say goodbye to Dr. Atul and Dr. Rupa Shah. And we are very happy and we are proud of you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you everyone.
We'll end the show today. We have crossed 8:29, means almost one. Our live is 1 hour 21 minutes and 31 seconds. So we have crossed our limit. But
yes,
we are very happy that everyone gets some knowledge.
Yes, okay. Still comments are popping up, but abde pachi lesu. Thank you so much, everyone. We will see you soon. Thank you. Good night. Take care and good morning. Bye. Please join us tomorrow.
Yeah. Thank you to all the viewers and participants who have given their comments about it. Thank you. We appreciate.
Thank you. Thank you all. Thank you.
Thank you. And please join tomorrow. Don't forget, tomorrow you will get to know about Australia, the situation there of COVID and how doctors manage there. So always new doctors, new topics, and please watch our COVID awareness shows. Bye everyone.
Thank you. Bye and good night.
Thank you.